Merhabalar, ben Sercan. Before learning how we introduce ourselves in Turkish, we're going to see something else, and this is about vowel omission in Turkish. Well, this is another function in the Turkish language to make the pronunciations easier and smoother. I know, we have already seen many fundamental principles in Turkish, such as vowel harmony, consonant mutation, and buffer letters. So this is just another one. Okay, here is the rule. When a suffix that begins with a vowel is attached to certain words that end with a consonant, the last vowel of this word is omitted. I repeat once again. When a suffix that begins with a vowel is attached to certain words which end with a consonant, the last vowel of this word is omitted. Now let's see an example. İsim, isim, this means name. Let's add possessive suffixes to this word. In this case, since isim ends with a consonant and the last vowel of the word is e, according to the vowel harmony, I need to use the following possessive suffixes. So, if you want to say my name, we take the word, which is isim, isim. Then, we add the possessive suffix for the first person, which in this case is im, and our word becomes isimim, isimim. Here, the vowel omission rule comes into action. The last vowel of the original word is omitted, and it becomes ismim, ismim. Now you can also try. Pronunciation of ismim, ismim is much easier than isimim, isimim. When we want to say your name, then it is ismin, ismin. When we want to say his name, her name, or its name, then it is ismi, ismi. So now let's make a sentence. Benim ismim Sercan. Benim ismim Sercan, which means my name is Sercan. Another one. Onların isimleri gerçekten çok güzel. Onların isimleri gerçekten çok güzel. Which means their names are truly beautiful. Okay, let's see another word. Akıl. Akıl, which means mind. We're going to use the possessive suffixes once again for this word. This time, we're going to add also the possessive adjectives. Benim aklım, benim aklım, which means my mind. Senin aklın, senin aklın, which means your mind. Onun aklı, onun aklı, which means his, her, or its mind. Bizim aklımız, bizim aklımız, which means our mind. Sizin aklınız, sizin aklınız, which means your mind. Onların aklı, onların aklı, which means their mind. Maybe you have already realized the vowels in the suffixes are the same as the vowels that are omitted. And in general, the nouns that have two syllables and having ı, i, u, ü in their second syllable, those vowels are the ones that are omitted. Let's take a look at our examples once again. We used two words, isim and akıl. Both of them have two syllables and one of them has ı, the other one has i as a vowel in their second syllable. Now I'm going to give you some additional examples. Beyin, beyin, which means brain. If you want to say his, her, or its brain, then we say beyni, beyni. If you want to add the possessive adjective as well, then we will say onun beyni, onun beyni. Sabır, sabır, which means patience. Well, when somebody has a lot of patience, in Turkish we will say this person has peygamber sabrı, peygamber sabrı, which means a patience of a prophet. Vakit, vakit, which means time, occasion. If you want to say breakfast time, we will say kahvaltı vakti, kahvaltı vakti. Şehir, şehir, this means city. If we want to say our city, we will say şehrimiz, şehrimiz. There are definitely more examples, but I think that's enough for today and for now. There is one additional point I would like to mention. We have already seen that the word şehir, şehir, is one of the words with vowel omission. Şehre gidiyorum, şehre gidiyorum, which means I'm going to the city. However, the city names that include the word şehir in them are not affected by this rule, because the actual city or town names are proper names. Let's see some examples. Eskişehir'e gidiyorum, Eskişehir'e gidiyorum, which means I'm going to Eskişehir. As you see, here the vowel omission rule does not take place. So you wouldn't say Eskişehir'e gidiyorum, Eskişehir'e gidiyorum. You have to say Eskişehir'e gidiyorum, Eskişehir'e gidiyorum. Another example, Kırşehir'in nüfusu çok fazla değil. Kırşehir'in nüfusu çok fazla değil. Which means the population of Kırşehir is not that much. Alright guys, we have learned something new today. Please check this video once again and take some notes. In the next video, we are going to learn how to introduce ourselves in Turkish and in detail. If you have any questions, please let me know. See you in the next video. Görüşmek üzere.